Becoming a tech writer might be easier than other professions, but being successful as a tech writer is a completely different game. The role of a tech writer in a modern software company, 90% is about technology and then 10% is writing. In the past couple of months, I've been interacting with a lot of new tech writers who either find me through this channel or through the Season of Docs program. And I find myself answering the same questions and giving the same advice over and over again. So I thought it would be a good idea to just sit down and record a video so that more people can benefit from the answers. So when a person who is new to tech writing or wants to become a tech writer approaches me for advice, the first question I ask them is, why do you want to become a tech writer? Do you have any prior experience where you had to write about technology and you really liked the experience, so now you want to explore the field a bit more? For example, my introduction to the field of tech writing was when I was pursuing my engineering degree and we had to write a lot of engineering reports. And I realized that I liked the writing the reports part more than actually working on the technology. If you can think of some memory or some experience where you had to learn and explain technology and you absolutely loved that experience, that is a good indication that tech writing might be the right field for you. Another surprising reason that people tell me that they want to become tech writers is that they have been told that it is easy to become a tech writer. And if you have been following my videos, you know that is not true. Becoming a tech writer might be easier than other professions, but being successful as a tech writer is a completely different game. So you have to understand that there are different types of tech writing jobs, and some of them are the low-hanging fruit, which is the boring, menial documentation, and those jobs are pretty easy to get. But once you are a few years into the career, breaking out of those jobs and into the lucrative, challenging opportunities is very difficult. If the only reason you're thinking of tech writing as a career is that you think it is easy, you need to do more research. But if you genuinely like learning and explaining technology, then this would be an excellent field to be in. I personally find it very rewarding, challenging, and lucrative. So how do you find out if tech writing is the right career for you? Like, would you enjoy writing about technology, say, 10 years down the line? One way to find that out is by experimenting. I'm a big believer in trying out different roles before you commit to them. And one way to do that would be to contribute to open source projects or to volunteer for a non-profit organization and offering to write their documentation. This will help you realize if you actually like the tech writing process. Do you like teaching yourself about new technology, reading about it, going and talking to people about it, getting information, figuring out the right way to explain that technology to other people, also getting reviews, getting feedback on your writing. So going through this process, either for an open source project or a nonprofit, will help you realize if you really enjoy the tech writing process. And can you see yourself doing it for years? So experimenting with a tech writing project is one way to figure out if you want to be a tech writer. Another way to figure out is to immerse yourself in the field. Read books about tech writing, read blogs by tech writers, listen to podcasts, watch YouTube channels like this one. I hope this channel gives you enough insight into life as a tech writer and helps you make an informed decision about if this is the right career for you. But apart from my channel, I have three recommendations for you to figure out more about the field. The first is one of my favorite technical writing books called Modern Technical Writing by Andrew Etta. Very short read. I think it is just 90 pages or like less than 10,000 words. But Andrew does a fantastic job of portraying the life of a modern tech writer. As an industry, I think we have moved on from robo-help and the books-based help, the traditional form of tech writing. And I think Andrew does a good job of explaining the transition into modern tech writing, which is more XML and topic-based authoring and GitHub and Markdown and the newer tools. He also talks in detail about the role of a tech writer in a modern software company. I find his description accurate. He talks about how tech writers, we test the product and we are the user's advocates, and then we happen to write. Like, writing is probably like 10% of the tech writing job. More, 90% is about technology and then 10% is writing, is my personal opinion of the field. And he does an excellent job of explaining the role of a tech writer. So I highly recommend that you read this book if you're interested in becoming a tech writer. I'll leave the link to his book in the description box below. My second favorite resource to learn about the field of tech writing is Tom Johnson's blog, I'd Rather Be Writing. He has been blogging about his life as a tech writer for over a decade now. And I find his documentation of his journey as a tech writer to be a record of the evolution of the field. Like, he started off with the traditional model of tech writing, and if you see his current blog posts, they're more modern. So I think reading his blog not only gives you insight into life as a tech writer, but also how the career progression could work over a decade. And my final recommendation to find out more about the tech writing field is the podcast 10 Minute TechCom. As the name suggests, the podcast is all about 10-minute interviews with different technical writers about an aspect of technical communication. The reason I love this podcast is because it gives you insight into different aspects of technical communication that you might not work on yourself, but it's still good to be exposed to those concepts and see if you can use them in your work and if that is something you see yourself doing in the future. And a bonus recommendation if you're thinking about becoming a tech writer is to check out this thread on Reddit, which has answers to all the questions you could possibly ask about a career in tech writing. How do you break into tech writing as a new graduate? What kind of salary can you expect? What kind of jobs are possible? Can you transition to tech writing from different fields? So if you're seriously thinking about a career in tech writing, I sincerely recommend that you check out the book, Modern Technical Writing, Tom Johnson's blog, the 10-Minute TechCom podcast, and this Reddit thread. Okay, so let's assume that you have gone through all the resources and you're sure that you want to pursue a career in tech writing. Then it brings us to our second most commonly asked question, what course should I take? So when people ask me for course recommendations, the first question I ask them is, what kind of course are you looking for and why are you looking for it? The most common answer is for certification. And this was a very surprising answer to me, because when I interview tech writers for tech writing positions at Cockroach Labs, I never look for certifications. The things we look for are how they perform on the take-home test, how they perform on the interview, did they interact well with the engineers, were they able to get the right information from the engineers. But I thought that was a possibility that I have a very small sample size, like I don't look for certifications when I'm interviewing tech writers, but that does not mean that the industry does not look for certifications. So I asked my network, I conducted a poll on LinkedIn, Reddit, and Facebook, and I asked my fellow technical writers, especially the hiring managers, if they look for certifications. And the answer was, we do not look for certifications, we look for experience, and we look for tech writing skills and how they perform on the interviews. So if you are someone who is considering a course just for the certification, think again. I also had people send me links to certain courses and ask me to look at them and see if I think they are valuable enough to invest time and money into them. And looking at some of the courses was again very surprising to me, because I couldn't figure out if the person offering the course was qualified to offer the course. Like, some of the websites for the courses had grammatical errors and their designs were, I don't know, from which century. So if you can't communicate information about your product effectively, how can you teach someone else to communicate clearly? And is the instructor qualified to teach tech writing? Like, have they worked in the industry themselves? Do they have tech writing experience? Have they worked with technology? So I think it's kind of become a pet peeve of mine that there are so many courses being offered for tech writing, and I don't think any of them are worth it. And they charge like these exorbitant amounts of money, like 25,000 rupees for a tools-based course. Like, why do you need somebody to teach you a tool? For example, FrameMaker. Just download a trial copy, watch YouTube videos, read their documentation, like do a sample project, and you will learn FrameMaker. So to end this rant, I guess my recommendation is that ask yourself, why do you want to do a course? If you decide that you do need a course, don't do it for the certification. Look for the credentials of the person offering the course and do not take a tools-based course. Please save your money and your time and invest it in something else. But I do not think you need a course to learn tech writing tools. Which brings us to a final frequently asked question, and that is, what tools should I learn? I think that's the wrong question to ask. The right question to ask is, what kind of documentation do you want to work on? If you want to work on user documentation, my recommendation is to learn a wiki-based tool like Confluence, and probably a screenshotting tool like Snagit. If you want to work on developer documentation, I recommend that you learn GitHub or Markdown. And I highly recommend that you learn at least one programming language. And my recommendation is Python. I hope this video was helpful. If you have additional questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. And if you are an experienced tech writer, please comment below and share your favorite tips, advice, and resources for new tech writers. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, happy writing.